Brother Kual will pray for us for the Sunday school, and after that we will begin the class. Okay, Kual. Hey. Pray for the Sunday school.
Amen.
Thank you, Kual. Since today is Father's Day, and to speak about Father is really a difficult topic for me, because from my childhood, when I come into this world, I never have a father, so it's really difficult for me to speak about what does it feels like to have a good father. At the same time, how does it feels like to have a dad? Okay. This will be our topic for today. Happy Father's Day and the importance of good relationship with father. And why it is so important to have a good relationship with father, even though you might be a girl or a boy, that is, it doesn't matter what gender you are. The most important thing is father is really important in our life. At the same time, to have a good relationship with our father is much, much important than just to have a father. Okay, let's move in. Faith of the faithless and the psychology of atheism. Atheism means a person who doesn't believe in God. And this is a book written by Paul Sivitz, and he talked about why it is so important for a person to have a father. And the reason he say is this. In his book, he talked about this guy, the picture that he showed, we call him Friedrich Nietzsche. He's a very well-known philosopher. At the same time, he's a person who doesn't believe in God, the existence of God. And he's a well-known person. When you come to high schools or undergrad, you'll begin to know more about him. He doesn't believe in God. And at the same time, this person, Voltaire, he's also a very well-known philosopher. At the same time, he also don't believe in the existence of God. And he say, I don't believe in the existence of God. And this woman, he stay in the United States. Madeleine Murray O'Hare, she also does not believe in the existence of God. And my question is, why this very well-known persons and very well-educated person doesn't believe in God? And according to Paul Sivitz, he's a psychologist and he studies about their life. And what he found out is this. All this person, Friedrich Nietzsche, Voltaire, and O'Hare, all this person doesn't have a father in their life. All this well-known person, a person who doesn't believe in God, when they don't have a father in their life, that absence of father make it very difficult to understand who God is. So when a person don't have a father in their life, the most difficult thing they found when it comes to religion is, how can I believe in God? Or how can I believe in God the Father? So when a person doesn't have a father in their life, it is very difficult for them to believe in the existence of God. And that is what he found out. Okay. And let's move on.
Mommy,
I wanted to...
Years ago, I interviewed Kwesi Nfume, then the president of the NAACP. As between the presence of white racism and the absence of black fathers, I asked him, which poses the bigger threat to the Black community? Without missing a beat, he said, the absence of Black fathers. It was President Barack Obama who said, we all know these statistics, that children who grow up without a father are 5 times more likely to live in poverty and commit crime, 9 times more likely to drop out of school, and 20 times more likely to end up in prison. The Journal of Research on Adolescence confirms that even after controlling for varying levels of household income, kids in father-absent homes are more likely to end up in jail. And kids who never had a father in the house are the most likely to wind up behind bars. In 1960, 5% of America's children entered the world without a mother and father married to each other. By 1980, it was 18%. By 2000, it had risen to 33%, and 15 years later, the number reached 41%. For Blacks, even during slavery, when marriage for slaves was illegal, Black children were more likely than today to be raised by both their mother and father. Economist Walter Williams has written that, according to census data from 1890 to 1940, a Black child was more likely to grow up with married parents than a white child. For Blacks, out-of-wedlock births have gone from 25% in 1965 to 73% in 2015. For whites, from less than 5% to over 25%, and for Hispanics, out-of-wedlock births have risen to 53%. What happened to fathers? The answer is found in a basic law of economics. If you subsidize undesirable behavior, you will get more undesirable behavior. In 1949, the nation's poverty rate was 34%. By 1965, it was cut in half to 17%, all before President Lyndon Johnson's so-called war on poverty. But after that war began in 1965, poverty began to flatline. From 1965 until now, the government has spent over $20 trillion to fight poverty. The poverty rate has remained unchanged, but the relationship between poor men and women has changed dramatically. That's because our generous welfare system allows women, in effect, to marry the government. And this makes it all too easy for men to abandon their traditional moral and financial responsibilities. Psychologists call such dependency learned helplessness. How do we know that the welfare state creates disincentives that hurt the very people we're trying to help? They tell us. In 1985, the Los Angeles Times asked both the poor and the non-poor whether poor women often have children to get additional benefits. Most of the non-poor respondents said no. However, 64% of poor respondents said yes. Now, who do you think is in a better position to know? Tupac Shakur, the late rapper, once said, I know for a fact that had I had a father, I'd have some discipline, I'd have more confidence. He admitted he began running with gangs because he wanted the things a father gives to a child, especially to a boy, structure and protection. Your mother cannot calm you down the way a man can, Shakur said. You need a man to teach you how to be a man. In my book, Dear Father, Dear Son, I write about my rough, tough World War II Marine Staff Sergeant dad. Born in the Jim Crow South of Athens, Georgia, he was 14 at the start of the Great Depression. Growing up, I watched my father work 2 full-time jobs as a janitor. He also cooked for a rich family on the weekends and somehow managed to go to night school to get his GED. When I was 10, my father opened a small restaurant that he ran until he retired in his mid-80s. He was never angry or bitter, and insisted that today's America was very different from the world of racial segregation and limited opportunity in which he grew up. Hard work wins, he told me and my brothers. You get out of life what you put into it. You can't control the outcome, but you are 100% in control of the effort. And before blaming other people, go to the nearest mirror and ask yourself, what could I have done to change the outcome? This advice shaped my life. Fathers matter. Until we have a government policy that makes that its first priority, nothing will change. I'm Larry Elder for Prager University.
Okay, what we learn here is this: father is really important in our life, and especially here in the United States. Many of the blacks and what we call the Latinos, or let's say the Spanish speaking, many of them don't have a father, and that has really great impact on their life. Same way, some of the girls there and some of the boys sitting in front of me, I just want to teach you this. When you grow up, choose wisely who is going to be your husband. And guys, if you want to have a wife, try to be a good father, because the way you become a father is really going to affect your children who is going to grow up in the United States. Right now, fatherless is really affecting the black community and at the same time the Spanish community. So we the Jomi, or we let's say we the Amy, what type of family do we want to have when we grow up? Do you want to have a children without father, or do you want to have a father leaving the children so that we can left them out and without any responsibility from ourselves, so that the children will suffer at the same time the mom will suffer? So I wanted to choose wisely what type of husband do you want in your life when you grow up. And the second, if you are a man, be a man. That's my advice. Not just to have a wife and without any responsibility being a father or a husband. Here, the picture that is in front of you is Wesley Pascal. He's a mathematician, a physicist, inventor, writer, and Catholic theologian. Theologians means a person who study the scripture. He is a mathematician, at the same time a physicist, and an inventor. And the other one is William Wilberforce. William Wilberforce is the one who ended the movement, or let's say he was the one who started the movement called the End of Slavery. He's from the United Kingdom, and he's a Christian. The one that I talk about, the first picture here, the guy, he's also a Christian, and this guy is also a Christian. And he says slavery is wrong. When the white bring us slavery from Africa, like the black, maybe like the Chinese or different places, and this guy say slavery is wrong, and this should be stopped. And he was the one who started the movement. And second, then Dietrich Bonhoeffer, he's from Germany. He's the one who started a movement called in Nazi Germany. During the time of Hitler captured many Jewish people and he kept in a place called concentration camp. But when he kept there, these people were kept in a chamber, means in one room, and they were left to die there without any mercy. So Dietrich Bonhoeffer said this is injustice and this is wrong. So he fought against Nazi Germany, what we call Hitler. Then he was killed there also. So all these person like Pascal, William Wilberforce, and Bonhoeffer, who are these people? How did they know that there is something injustice, and why did they fight for people's rights? According to the research that we find is this: all of these people have a good relationship with their father. All of them had a great relationship with their dad and were therefore more able to build relationship with God. So when you have a good relationship with your father, you are able to build even a good relationship with God, and you can know what is right and wrong better than a person who doesn't have a father in your life. So why a father or a dad is really important in our life is because when you have a good relationship with your father, at the same time when you have a dad, you are able to know what is right and wrong better than the person who doesn't know, who doesn't have father. So building a good relationship is really important with your father. At the same time, to have a father in our life is really important, so that we can build a good relationship with God. And this is the video for the last video for us today. And I want you to learn something from this video, how much your father loves you, even though they may not be the perfect dad. Okay. Hold on. Let me play from another place then.
No. What happened? What the? No. I don't know.
พ่อที่ไม่เป็นใบ พ่อที่เหมือนคนอื่น พ่อที่ได้ยินในสิ่งที่หนูอยากบอก พ่อที่พูดได้แล้วก็เข้าใจหนูได้
Okay. What I want to teach you today is that we may not have a perfect father, but your dad always loves you. Remember this. And father play a very important role in human life when it comes to relationship with God, at the same time, when it also the relationship with the society. So what type of father do you want to be when you grow up? At the same time, what type of mother? And what, yes, if you are going to become a mom, what type of husband should you choose? Be very careful in that. So today, I remember that those who have a father, you are very lucky. And people like me, I never experienced what does it feel like to be loved by a father. But I'm still glad that I have a Heavenly Father who is always watching over me. So since today is Father's Day, those who have father, thank your dad, and those who don't have anymore, just thank God that he is there for you. Okay, everyone, have a great day. If you have any questions to ask, you can ask me.
Bye.
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 Bye. Bye. Bye. Bye. Bye.